السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الدين عند الله الإسلام بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون Respected chief guest on the dais, Shri N. Ramesh, Chief Additional Medical Superintendent, and all the other dignitaries present on the dais, and everybody present here, I welcome all of you with Islamic greetings. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. The basic topic of this event is unity in diversity. I have seen the logos on the chest of everybody here, I mean the tag stuck there. The topic is unity in diversity. So what does Islam says about unity in diversity? We will say it in the course of our talks. But before that, many of our speakers in English, I think in English, Hindi and Telugu, they have given the introduction of Islam, Ramadan and everything. I do not want to go into the detail of those topics. But as a course of talks, I'll give few, you know, one statement introduction, inshallah. Islam is based on five pillars. For everything you see in your life, for anything you build up, there are some pillars for everything. In the same way, Islam has got five pillars. If you read the hadith, there are the books of hadith present here. Hadith meaning the traditions, the sayings of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Quran is totally the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, meaning the sayings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And hadith meaning the traditions, the sayings of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam are different, are in different books. It's not mixed up again. So the hadith, if you read Sahih al-Bukhari, volume number 1, hadith number 8, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said that Islam is based on five pillars. What are those pillars? The very first pillar is Shahadatain. What is Shahadatain? La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, meaning there is no God but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the last and final messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the first witness we have to give. Tawheed, Salah, the second pillar. As soon as you have given the witness, as soon as you have accepted that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Lord and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the messenger, the very next step God Almighty asks us to do is bow down in prayer. The Salah, the five time prayers that is compulsory on every Muslim. Five times Salah. Tawheed, the very first. Salah, Zakah. Zakah is the annual charity which we Muslims give on the percentage of gold, silver and on the cash. Those are the different percentage on every other thing. The third pillar basically is charity. Can you imagine? The pillar, the basic pillar of a religion is charity. Charity is the pillar of our belief. This is the highest degree. Tawheed, Salah, Zakah, Saum. Saum is fasting. What is fasting in the month of Ramadan? We fast for 30 days. And that fasting is the training for Muslims. Training in the way that for the 11 months, unintentionally, if you have committed any mistake, if you have committed any sin, God Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is here. He has given 1 month for our training. He said that if you can retrieve, if you can stay away from permitted things, if you can stay away from permitted things during fast, why can't you stay away with prohibited things during the 11 months of Ramadan, 11 months, 11 other months? Got the point? If you can stay away from permitted things for 11 months apart from Ramadan, you can stay away from prohibited things. So this is the Saum. The fasting is the training for Muslims. The and Tawheed, Salah, Zakah, Saum, fifth one is Hajj. What is Hajj? The annual pilgrimage for Muslims to go to the house of Allah, Kaabatullah, and perform Hajj. If you are financially sound, physically sound, it is compulsory for them that they should go to the house of Allah and perform Hajj. These are the five pillars of Islam that every Muslim should follow, inshallah. Apart from this, if you see that the religion of Islam is the religion who does not degrade anybody. Islam does not degrade anybody, and it does not teaches its followers to degrade anybody. You see the verses, the ayahs of the glorious Quran, the hadith of the glorious Quran, the beautiful, you know, the incident of that old woman which was narrated by Brother Munawar, the beautiful incident you have heard just now. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not degrade that old woman. This is the beauty of Islam. This is the teachings of Islam. You see, unity. Many times what we do that when we meet non-Muslims, many people, the people who are less in knowledge, they try to degrade. They try to degrade on the basis of their religion. Arey, this person is a Christian man. He is just going to hell. He is a Hindu. Gone. Finished. He is going to hell. So I am just giving the judgment. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the verse, the ayat in the glorious Quran, the very first chapter, the surah. He says, Maliki Yawmiddin, the master, the judge of the day of judgment. He is the judge, we are not the judges. But sometimes you do that, whenever you see a non-Muslim, we give the judgment. This should not be done. This is against Islam. If you read the glorious Quran in Surah Maida, Surah number 5, ayat number 82, God Almighty said that the nearest to the belief of a Muslim, the nearest to the belief of a Muslim are those who say we are Christians. The nearest to the belief of a Muslim are those who say we are Christian, because among them they are some people who are learned. Kya kaha Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ne? Musalmanon se kharib mein, iman mein sabse kharib kaun hai? Isai hai kaha. Kyun? Unhone Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam se ek khadam pehle liya. They are one step behind Islam. Why? Because if they take one step forward, they will accept Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So this is the izzah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave in the glorious Quran. Now many a times you might have seen the youngsters or the people who do not have any knowledge of Islam, they try to revile against the gods of other religions. They say bad about other religions. They say bad about the gods of other religions. What did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say in the glorious Quran? If you read Surah An'am, Surah number 6, ayat number 208, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, do not say anything bad about the gods of other religions. What is the ayah? Do not say anything bad to the gods of other religions. Because unintentionally, if they say anything bad about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the sin is upon you. So can you imagine the teachings of Islam? If you do not accept God Almighty, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Lord, and you accept anybody other than Allah as God, Allah said, do not say bad about anything to that God. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, you cannot enforce religion on anybody. You cannot force religion. If you have guts to accept the truth, you accept it. If you do not accept the truth, you don't want to accept the truth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, La ikraha fid din. There is no compulsion in religion. There is no enforcement in the matters and the concepts of religion, in the issue of religion. Many people say that, you know, Islam was spread on the point of sword. Talwar se pura jo hai, what? Islam was spread on the point of sword. Talwar se pura duniya ko Islam bata hai. Can you imagine the phrase present day world? According to pewforum.org, that website, the population website, say that there are about 700 crore people on the face of the earth, meaning 7 billion people living on this earth now. If you give sword to 200 crore Muslims, 2 billion Muslims on the face of the earth, can you imagine the other 500 crore people will be living? No. Islam was spread by the ethics, the etiquettes, the teachings, the akhlaq that was given by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Again, the story of that old lady accepted Islam through the etiquettes of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And many companions of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam accepted Islam only by seeing the attire, only by seeing the etiquettes of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is Islam. You cannot enforce religion on anybody. This is the basic tagline of Islam, inshallah. So the few incidents about the relationship of Muslims and non-Muslims that was given by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You see, at the time of battle, at the time of battle, when Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was informed, oh Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, curse these non-Muslims. What did he say? Curse these non-Muslims. The reply of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was, no, 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 I cannot curse them because these people are my ummah. What did he say to the non-Muslims? These people are my ummah. Why this attitude? Why this etiquette? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the glorious Quran, in Surah Anbiya, Surah number 21, ayat number 107, he says, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. O Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you cannot curse anybody, instead, but you are the mercy for whole of the universe. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, I am the Lord, the Cherisher, the Sustainer for everything that exists. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. I am the Lord of the universe and you are the mercy for the same universe. This is the status of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Can you imagine a person with high status curse the people? No. At the time of Fateh Makkah, when the victory of Makkah took place, the Kuffar Makkah, the non-Muslims were terrified. Now today is the last day for our life. Today is the last day. They were terrified because 13 years of difficulties that was faced by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam because of these people. Now when Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the companions conquered Makkah, they were terrified because they said today is our last day. But when Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam entered Makkah through his victory conquering the land, he said, today is the day I will show up my mercy to these people. Can you imagine? 13 years of difficulties faced by those people, Kuffar Makkah, and to the toppest point of difficulties that was given by those people to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But at the end, my Prophet, our Prophet said, today is the day I will shower mercy on these people. This is the attitude, this is the etiquette of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam towards non-Muslims. The last incident, at the time of Taif, the incident of Taif, when Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam traveled to Taif by walk, not on the motorcycle, not on the aeroplane, not on any four-wheeler, 100 kilometers from Makkah, he traveled to Taif by walk. For what? Business. For what? To take the luxuries of this world? No. He went to Taif to teach Islam to those people for their benefit, for the benefit of the non-Muslims. When he went there, you know, the small kids, they threw stones upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The body of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was, you know, full of blood. The blood was, you know, flowing through his feet. That amount of torture that was given to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam by the people of Taif, by the kids of Taif. What did he say? The angels of that area came down. Jibril alayhi salam, the angel Gabriel came down and he said, he proposed to Prophet. He said, oh Prophet, if you give me permission, we will destroy these people with the permission of Allah. If you give me permission, we will destroy these people who have tortured you. The reply of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was, no, 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 no. Even today, still, I believe that from these people, there will be some people who will come up and say, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah. This was the teaching of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This was the attitude of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Can you imagine if somebody give you a cut while driving, will you keep quiet? What is our attitude? What is the Hyderabadi attitude? What is the Hyderabadi attitude? If you drive fast, अरे भाई मरने जा रहा, इफ यू ड्राइव स्लो बाकी रोड है, इफ यू गिव ए कट पागल हो गया ये नहीं, या दीस आर द सम फ्रेजेस व्हिच वी यूज इन हैदराबाद, राइट? दिस इज अवर एटीट्यूड, यू कैन नॉट यू नो टेक अ कट विद इन फ्रंट ऑफ एनीबॉडी, यू कैन नॉट यू नो बर्दाश्त नहीं होता हमसे वो, बट द स्टेटस ऑफ प्रॉफिट मोहम्मद सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम, the blood of prophet muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is flowing, but he gave the forgiveness to those people. This is the status of non muslims in islam. This attitude we muslims should adopt from the teachings of the basic main thing is that we muslims have gone away from the teachings of prophet, we muslims have gone away from the teachings of quran, we muslims have never read the incidents of prophet muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We are very much busy in our lives. This is the truth that I am speaking about today. The conclusion part of my topic is unity in diversity. As you have seen, the main heading of this program is unity in diversity. What is unity and what is diversity? In what concept we are united and in what concept we are divided? Got the point? In what concept we are united and in what concept we are divided? We are first we I'll talk about division, then we'll go with the unity. We are different in our beliefs. We are different in our rituals. We are different in our practices of religion, right? We are different in our belief, rituals and practices, and we are united. Why? United for Muslim and non-Muslim is united to arrange a iftar party. Muslims and non-Muslims are united for to arrange a dinner party. For what we are united? We are united to curb the anti-social evils of the society. We are united to curb anti-social elements of the society. We are united to curb anti-national people in this India. Got the point? We are united for what? For the bigger thing. The bigger thing is that to curb bad things that are coming up in the society, anti-social evils, anti-social elements, anti-national people. We are united to curb all this, and we are divided in our beliefs, rituals and practices. I would just like to end with a phrase. I know whether I have memorized it or not, but I try to memorize it. The stanza of Allama Iqbal, he said, mazhab nahi sikhata aapas mein bair rakhna. Religion does not teach you to be different in your thinking. If you are, you know, believing in different concepts, you cannot, you know, totally different in all the concepts. We can be united for what? To curb bad things in the society. What did Allama Iqbal say? Mazhab nahi sikhata aapas mein bair rakhna. Hindi hai hum watan hai, Hindustan hamara, Chino Arab hamara. चीनो अरब हमारा, हिंदुस्तान हमारा, मुस्लिम है हम वतन है, सारा जहां हमारा. दिस इज द स्टैंजा ऑफ प्रॉफेट, दिस इज द स्टैंजा ऑफ अल्लामा इकबाल. सो वी आर यूनाइटेड टू कर्ब ऑल द एंटी सोशल इवल्स एंड लिव हैप्पीली यूनाइटेडली टू डेवलप दिस नेशन इंडिया इंशाल्लाह. जज़ाकअल्लाह खैर. वा आखिर दावाना अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह रब्बिल आलमीन.